Hey everybody, and welcome to part 8 of Ratchet and Clank Going Commando. So, funny thing is, part 6 was not staticky, it was actually part 7. Weird how that actually happened when I clearly had it planned, so you know. I don't know, like sometimes it plays back staticky on mine, and then sometimes it doesn't. So maybe it fixes itself time to time, other times it doesn't, so Yo, take care of those guys for me, please, while I destroy the city. Like I said, Ratchet just destroys all the cities that he goes to. Like, oh, destroy this. Man, we need 65,000 volts, and we only have 11,000. We're not even halfway there. Like I said, though, there are challenges that I actually might go do them in the next episode. Or in this episode, if we have time, if I don't want to, go to the next planet or something, just in case there's not, a short part to it. Like, if the next planet's planet Siberius, or even, the one planet I'm thinking of, then we'll go there. Also, that looks... Ah, I see how this is going to be. We're going to have to go in here. Because clearly, the one way we had went didn't do anything other than give us one extra nanotech. Like how it tells us what it does, though. It's it gives you nanotech. Obviously. As soon as we picked it up, we gained one health. I believe there's two or three of those in the game. And what they do is they just literally give you the nanotech that you can miss out on. You can miss out on it. And actually, hang on, let me just check something real quickly. Nah, I was just checking to make sure my girlfriend didn't message me. But no, there's nothing. Unless I got a message from her on Facebook and it just didn't do the whole... No. 1 hour ago. Perfect. Now, I mean, not perfect that she's not talking to me, just perfect that I didn't miss out on anything. Screw this, I'm just gonna destroy it with this. And apparently none of the other enemies got destroyed by it. That's funny. You don't want to fire it too fast, right after one another, because then you'll literally just hit the same enemy, even if that enemy's technically dead. It's a real bummer. And there we go. All our ammo's back to full. Oh, I thought this was a ship. Oh, no, there's the ship. Some of them have really long range, though, so you gotta be careful. I'm gonna fire right in his barrel, so that way he dies no matter what. Should have died, man. Your ammunition would have caught on fire. And you would have blew up from the inside out. Nah, they wouldn't make Ratchet and Clank like that. I've never actually played the new one for PS4 that came out almost a year ago now, right? Actually, I believe one of the platinum bolts is around here. As for those guys, we'll just use our Seeker again. Seeker's gonna be a very slow weapon to level up. Because I don't think it's the next arena planet next. Because yes, like most games, there's generally two, since going back to the one on this doesn't really do anything. Also, those are bombs. Also, that's the dynamo. Oh, okay, so we're gonna have to find out where that is. Is it over there? Oh, wait, is it still going? Yeah, it is. Oh, that thing lasts a long time, so we'd have a lot of time to finish it. We just need to, actually do it, so... Seeker, go! See? Accidentally fired one. Ow. My girlfriend's apparently really excited. Let me just answer that real quickly. I apologize. I don't know what she's excited for. She also picked me up something from the Calgary Zoo, which I'm actually excited to see. I've been to the zoo once, but half the exhibits were closed. Well, I guess animals were closed up because of renovations. A few of them were there for her too, but Hopefully, you know, that that changes soon. There we go! We upgraded our pulse rifle to the vaporizer. Swear that's literally just the name of another weapon in another game. Boom! I'm just using this to destroy everything. You know, get some bolts quicker. He's using your wrench for everything all the time. Okay, can I, like, take a shortcut down there? We'll go use the... How far away can I use it on the dynamo? Alright, so let's go, go, go! There we are! Oh, yeah. Oh, there it is. It's literally a bolt. This is not the bolt that I was thinking of either. It really wasn't. So yeah, that's another upgrade that we can get, the lock-on mod. Well, I like how we instantly get locked in though. It's like, oh screw you man, we're just gonna lock you in. Wait, apparently this does not go through very many boxes. I believe the other one is like up on a ledge or something, like up on one of these areas. I'm not sure if it's close to here, but that's a continue point. I hear little buddies. Oh, you know what? Now it's a one-hit KO. Beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. Whoa, that was really weird. Hey, it's a TV. Let me guess, Mr. Doofus? Nope.
Got a ship that needs improvements? Worried about getting caught? At Slim Cognito's, your secret is safe with us. Whether it's weapons, shielding, or a new hyperspace module, we'll hook you up quickly, cheaply, and most important, quietly. So next time you're in the market for some legally ambiguous refashioning, remember the name. Slim Cognito's. The only inspections we pass are yours.
Starship mods. Well, a quick visit to Slim's wouldn't cost us much time. Or maybe we should check out that chemical factory. Someone inside might know where the thief was headed.
Yay! So now we can upgrade our ship. Funny thing is, we did all this literally just to get into that factory. It's honestly, seriously, all we did it for. Yeah, these should be able to fend them off for a bit. Okay, I swear they don't fire when you're not looking at them. Which is kind of a bummer. So I guess this entire episode just might be this planet, and maybe checking out the ship shack. Yeah, see? We want to go in there, I believe. Right? It's always like a pathway that I always miss out on for some reason. Oh wait, no, never mind, it's here. We're just on the other side of it now. Man, this thing levels up way slower than it did in the other game. Alright, we'll just pop one here, pop another one here. There we go. Come on, guys. Ow! Dude, you guys actually gotta shoot every now and then. Oh my god, a bolt crank. That's amazing. Let me guess, we're gonna have to use, I believe this is another Terminator area. So I'm pretty sure we're not gonna get our last gadget already. That would be a little bit insane in wall jumping. We use this, what, once? I think at the beginning of the game? There we go. Yep, this is the Terminator. I knew it was here. It reminds me of the Shermanator from American Pie. That was... A lot of people hated that series. I actually, for one, really enjoyed it. The original ones. Not like the ones where it's like Stifler's younger brother or whatever that, you know, takes over. Hate that series. Not funny. It's... Like, it wasn't even the fact that it wasn't the original cast that got me. It was just... I don't know. It just didn't turn out the way that I was expecting it. It wasn't half as funny as the other movies were. And that's just my personal opinion. Why did you... He let go to smack. That's a little weird, don't you think? What kind of bridges do these guys use in this game? Like, aren't they scared of, like, falling over? falling overboard or something. I just wish this weapon was a little bit faster. It's faster to melt, I swear, but freezing takes a while. Alright, in we go. And up we go again. Like, this honestly is not a hard planet to do. Well, I mean, not hard planet. Hard portion of the planet. There's a bolt crank down there that we gotta deal with. So, let's do this. Oh yeah, then we'll have to thaw it out and then go back around. Seems easy enough. Thaw! It's funny how, like, all just thaws at one time, though. It's like, all at once, go, go, go! It's like, oh wait, we're... You know, we should definitely not, just slowly melt. Should be like a point where you can't step on it, nor can you swim on it. Like, it would just, like, be slush, you know? Kind of cool. And then again, this is like one of the early PlayStation 2 games. And PlayStation 2 was amazing. Like, I'm not gonna lie, PlayStation 2 was da bomb. And okay, now I thought there might have been, like, a secret up there. Whoa! And apparently that was the checkpoint. I love how I don't get hit by the big bad enemies, I always get hit by like the little wussy enemies. So, up we go. Okay, this one's all about timing. And there's also that man-eating fish, which only shows up in the original three games. Never shows up again in any other series, apparently. Because apparently in the newer ones, Ratchet just drowns, which... I guess makes logical sense. You know, he definitely doesn't have a mask and, you know, Clank dude to do it. Yeah, I understand when he's not with Clank, but... Come on, man. Run! We almost got eaten by a fish! Oh, they almost give me a heart attack, man. Hey, we're at 20,000 now. 45,000 more to go. Do this, lower its temperature quite a bit, and then like such. I believe this is fine enough. Oh nope, it's not. God damn it! I absolutely hate this part. Oh, okay. So apparently you have to high jump because apparently Ratchet doesn't like to grab onto ledges that often. Here we go, upsy daisy. Now we gotta just time this right then. Don't completely freeze now, game. There we go, I think that's perfect. Because we need to be able to high jump. This is honestly, I think, like the final part, and it's also the hardest part, so... So you grab onto that ledge, but you can grab onto the other one. Now, don't fall over the ledge. Yeah, see, because now you want to redo this all again. Because they thought it was a good idea to constantly have to do this. Though I do love the snow effect. I don't believe there's a fish on this side, though. But I do believe he can get you on this side. He, like, swims through or something. I'm not... entirely sure on that. You guys can quote me if I'm wrong. Just don't be dicks about it. Oh. Never mind, we got this again. So... Hopefully that's enough. Pretty sure... Oh, this one just has a ladder, or one of those jumpy things. I hope we don't have to spend any money... Wait, that's not a jumpy one. We screwed up again, so yeah, we're probably definitely not going to be doing too much else on this, or in this video. This is one of those long planets that, once again, has, like, no skill points. Like, seriously. One skill point for the entirety of the planet? It's gotta be a joke, right? Oh, the water level's too low to freeze it. Ah, perfect! Can't really get too much higher. can. As long as we can high jump up, we're safe. Thank you. We did it. We got to the TV.
Perhaps these robots can assist us.
Excuse me. Have you seen any masked weirdos?
I think I had better do the talking. A masked customer picked up an order not long ago. Recently, they received a new transmission from him, and they are willing to show it to us for a small price.
Yeah, there goes half of the money we just earned.
Of sulfuric acid. Oops. Better make that 5 containers and 4 containers of liquid hydrogen. Oops. Better add 6 crates of nitroglycerin and... Look, just give me double that. And I need it delivered.
Hey! What? What?
Oh, nothing. Just some robot humor.
Okay, funny guy. Let's just head to those coordinates.
Oh, actually, it's not the planet I was thinking of. This is the planet that I thought if we could have got it done in time, we could go do, but I didn't realize, because according to my book... Oh, never mind. Cerberus is next. It's the next one after that. But yeah, we'll definitely go check out the ship shack and all that. Definitely, definitely. So we'll go do that right now. Actually, we might be able to do Cerberus in this episode as well. So let's go to this. Actually, you know what? Screw that. Let's go to Cerberus now. Find and confront the thief. So let's go. This is gonna be another 10 minutes on this video, then so be it. I'm not going anywhere. The only thing I have to do is fulfill my addiction to Pokemon Sun and Moon. But Planet Cerberus, the snowy planet. Hence, you know, being called Cerberus. Ooh, I love the crystalline sound effects. Once again, literally nothing. And when I mean nothing as in new weapons, so that's fine with me. Okay, no, you can't destroy them. Oh, there's a bolt up there. Oh, blade balls, really? Oh, man. Not looking forward to these little fudgers. Thank you. Also, 1 skill point here as well. Not really a fan of those balls. Oh. Oh, come on, dicks. You guys are just mean. Whoa, did he seriously live? Okay. Alright, now for these guys, we'll use some Seeker. Wow, this is strong enough to one-shot them. But, once again, still not a very good upgrade input, output, I don't know what you want to call it. It's not upgrade fast, that's for sure. But the fiery ones are a little stronger, unless you knock them off the cliff. Okay, now, it said the snow den was, like, by the door where the first robots come out. So I'm assuming here's one of the guys who helped create it. He actually passed away, which is sad, but skill point. I'm pretty sure that's worth a trophy as well. I thought maybe it was worth a trophy. Maybe not. I think it's only worth a trophy in the second game, or third game. This is the second game. What are you talking about, Willis? Yep. Ow. Oh. Well, thanks for the nanotech. I don't know if there's any armor upgrades in this game, though. I'm pretty sure there are, but it doesn't really feel like it. I think only certain planets have it. Oh, man. Can you not? Can you guys just leave me alone for, like, 2 seconds? So I can get out a weapon that could actually defeat you guys? Or you guys can just all go down there under... Okay, now you guys come up to harass me. Thanks, dicks. These guys are royal dicks. There we go, we're out of... poo. Okay, that didn't work. There, we'll just drop some more turrets. Ow! Oh man, these guys are relentless. Sweet, nanotech increase. Ooh, you actually destroyed the dropship as well. Not bad, little buddies. I'm not entirely sure how to go and get that other, whatchamacallit, that bolt over there at the beginning. Okay, why was it constantly throwing it in one direction? Oh yeah, this area, I remember this. Well, let's hop onto the giant vehicle. Because, you know, it's normal just to hop into a giant vehicle, right? Oh, snap. Mini turrets, go! Pop out three of them. That should be enough to take these guys down. Nope, apparently not. Two more? They're literally almost on the verge of dying. Swing shot, son. Perfect. Oh yeah, these guys again. I love that sound effect. Okay, apparently my shot just literally just disappeared. Whoa! Okay. Uncalled for game. Okay, sweet, it's just teleporting him in. Hey, boss! Die, thief! Oh, there you go. Adios. That's a joke, right? If that's the boss fight, I'm gonna laugh. God damn it. These guys, you know what? I'm not gonna waste ammo on you, because you guys are literally just jokes. These guys, on the other hand, not so much. There we go. Wasted a lot of ammo on them, but we got our weapon up halfway, finally. Okay, just for this, be careful not to fall off the ledge. And once again, gotta fight the boss. Hey, how much does our vaporizer do? Whoa. Wait, is that even... Oh, it's crashing.
Ah, we're gonna die!
Okay, no, this is where the actual boss fight is, okay. And, like, I swear the vaporizer should be doing more to a boss, right? Like, it one-shots everything. Why am I using it? Because I want to conserve ammo for the boss. And we got more of these little blade balls that these games are obsessed with. And like, this and Deadlock were obsessed with them. And the other games, not so much, but... Okay, return to our ship, you know, just in case you don't want to actually continue the story or anything. Alright, perfect. We'll swap into the Seeker.
Imperialistic eco-fascism to another dimension. Say goodbye to your Frankenfest.
Come on, Clank.
Too slow, you corporate lackey.
So it's literally like a freaking protester gone wild, an activist. Wow, this seems like a joke. Can you stop attacking them? There we go, defeat the boss with him. Thank you, man.
You had us worried for a moment. Do you suppose we should stop him?
Not worth it. We got what we came for. Let's just get that little guy back to Mr. Fizzwidget.
Ratchet? Spank? Is that you?
We've accomplished our mission, sir. The experiment is safe and in our possession.
Why, that's cutaneous! Absolutely munificent! You two are a galoptious team!
We were glad to assist, sir.
We just need coordinates to our next rendezvous point.
Of course. I'm on my way to give a tour of Megacorp's historical mining site. Here's a little pack talk on the fragility.
Megacorp Manufacturing and Mining, a tireless drum major leading the galaxy on its march of progress. Come tour our desert mining facility and see why our most precious product is our history. When we first arrived, we found a planet completely overrun by rainforest. To better accommodate the local wildlife, we transformed this impassable jungle into an easily navigable desert. Ever the technological pioneer, Megacorp invented the automated management team, thereby eliminating costly upward mobility, and all the while making your life richer. Megacorp Manufacturing and Mining. Our march continues to the tune of progress and profitability. Call Investor Relations today.
Yikes. Is that facility still operational, sir?
Alas, no. But it's steeped in hysterics. I've offloaded the condiments to your naval computer.
We'll see you there.
Naval computer. Wait. Just take me away? You're lucky I got the skill point done. I didn't actually want to come here yet. Thanks a lot, game. Planet Tabora. Now, this is the planet I was thinking of that was next, but nope.
Hey, there's Mr. Fizzwidget. What happened?
Everything's fine. There was just a bit of debris on the landing pad.
That was our ship.
Don't worry about it, little fella. It's insured. So, do you have the delivery? Terribulous! Come, gentlemen. There is precious little time. Just sit back and relax, boys. How about a little flying music?
Dick.
He did that on purpose.
Nah, he's just easily distracted.
Yeah, well...
Come on, let's see if we can find a way out of here.
Well, we're now down in the middle of nowhere. So in the next episode, guys, we'll be exploring the tunnels of Tabora. Also, we get